Coach, you could have gone back to talking amongst yourselves.
That was just to familiarise yourselves. So let me say again, a big welcome to each and every one of you. Some of you are here every week in life. Others of you are returning today for the first time since the pandemic, and you're very welcome. And others of you are in our church, perhaps for the first time. It doesn't matter who you are, where you've come from, why you're here, you are very, very welcome. For those who are unfamiliar, you'll understand that the Scottish Government restrictions are still in place. They vary from context to context. So here in church, we are still required to wear masks throughout the service, other than those who are involved, obviously, at the front. I know it's annoying. It's warm, it becomes claustrophobic, but that's the requirement that is on us, and we look to the day when it is lifted. That aside, we ask you to maintain distancing, and clearly you'll have sanitised your hands when you are coming in and coming through our track and trace system. So thank you for your understanding of where we remain at this time. I'm going to ask you to stand as Janice, our church officer, brings the Bible into our church. Let's all be standing. The psalmist says, may God be gracious to us and bless us, and make his face to shine upon us. Behold our God. We have all the words for our hymns and songs on the screens, but should we have technical problems, and we have had of late some issues, then everything you need is on the printed sheet in your hands. Behold our God.
Go on and sing, oh praise the name, I cast my mind to Calvary.
Praise the name of the Lord our God. Praise his name forevermore. See, all things change, but God's praise continues from everlasting to everlasting. For endless days, we will sing your praise, O Lord our God. And as we have said, God is good. So using the refrain, the chorus that we learned just a few moments ago, let's bow our heads. Of course, you can keep your head raised to see the screen if you would like. God is so good. Let us pray together. Loving God, it may be that we can be selfish and thoughtless and jealous and prideful, but you, God, are good.
God is so good. God is so good. God is so good.
Loving God, it may be that we can be lazy and irritable and impatient and bad-tempered, but you, God, are good.
God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me.
Loving God, it may be that we can be mean-spirited and evil-hearted and petty and ill-mannered, but you, God, are good.
God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good.
Loving God, it may be that we can be all of these things, but you are good. You are only good. And so by your love and by your amazing grace, you forgive us though we fall short day after day after day. For God, you are good. These and all our prayers we offer in Jesus' name. Amen. Isn't it good to be reminded that God is good always, and nothing has or ever will change that truth that God is good. You will see that we have models of two boats in our church, this one here on your right-hand side and the other one over here on our left. Ships were made to be on the sea. Now, yesterday, I was over on the west coast of Scotland, and the day before too, and the wind was blowing you like you wouldn't believe. 50 and 60 mile an hour winds howling. And just to add, it was raining at the same time. West and east in this country are so dramatically different. Well, yesterday on the west coast, it was blowing a hoolie. I think that's the phrase we sometimes use. And if you were on a boat or a ship in weather like that, you need something if you don't want your boat to be blown away by the wind and the waves. If you want your boat or your ship to stay put and not be blown away, who knows what that could be? Who knows what you would drop from your boat to keep it still? I see a hand up right here. Take your mask down for a moment and shout out.
An anchor.
An anchor. Well done. The correct answer. First time. Leah, were you going to say the same? I knew you were. Probably others too would know that you need an anchor to stop your boat drifting away when the wind gets up and when the storms come. Well, later on today, we're going to be thinking about this flag and some of what is on this flag. Can you see there? I'll put it round this way as well, and round here so everyone can see. There is an anchor on this flag. And two, at the top here, there is an anchor. And this anchor reminds us of a Bible verse in the New Testament, which tells us that God is our anchor in everything that happens in life. Sometimes life is quite easy and straightforward, but there are other times when life is tough, very, very tough. I think almost everyone has known some tough times in the last year or so. Hands up if there have been tough times in the last period of time. For me, for sure, and no doubt others of you. It can be a bit like that in life, like the winds and the storms of life come along. Now, are we going to be blown away, or are we going to stand firm in those tough times in life? We have an anchor that keeps us firm, that holds us rather than letting us be blown about. And the flag has it, and here it is right here. Now, the last piece of the jigsaw. On the flag, there is a red cross behind the anchor. You probably can't see it if you're way back, but towards the front, you can maybe see there is a red cross right behind the anchor. Now, I wonder if anyone knows what the red cross might stand for and might remind us of. Who might the red cross be reminding us about? Anybody can have a guess. Who's going to guess? You knew it was the anchor, but we've got a red cross in the background. Leah, you've got the hand up. You're thinking about it. Shout out. There you go. You knew it all the time. You just weren't sure, but you were absolutely right. You see, a boat needs an actual anchor, a big, heavy piece of metal that sinks to the bottom of the sea, sits there, and stops the boat from blowing around. Well, we have an anchor that keeps the soul, an anchor that helps us stand firm when life is really, really difficult. And our anchor is Jesus. I stand here today and say this: I don't know where I would be in life without having Jesus in my life, without having Jesus as the anchor for my whole life and, yes, for my soul. Well, much more about that later. But I want to say to each and every one of us, yes, in tough times, where will you look? Look to Jesus. Because he will keep you firm. Through good times and bad, through ups and downs, through twists and turns, Jesus is our anchor. Now we're going to sing the song we learned last week, a brilliant fishy music song. It's going to be a video backing track. I think you learned last week pretty well how the actions and things go, so let's all stand together. You can pick it up again if you're not familiar. Such an easy and great little song, reminding us the truth. Jesus is with us always. Always gonna be this way. seated. Sure, sometimes it feels like bad times are lasting forever, but with our anchor firmly in place, who is Jesus, good times will come. Amy and Rebecca are going to go through to our halls and lead our children through there. And Wilma, one of our elders here at St. Andrews, and of course, Captain of Boys Brigade, is going to come to the lectern and read our scriptures for today. So, boys and girls have got plenty lined up through in the hall. They can go there through now.
Our reading today is from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, reading from the Good News Bible. A time for everything. Everything that happens in this world happens at the time God chooses. He sets the time for birth and the time for death, the time for planting and the time for pulling up, the time for killing and the time for healing, the time for tearing down and the time for building. He sets the time for sorrow and the time for joy, the time for mourning and the time for dancing, the time for making love and the time for not making love, the time for kissing and the time for not kissing. He sets the time for finding and the time for losing, the time for saving and the time for throwing away, the time for tearing and the time for mending, the time for silence and the time for talk. And he sets the time for love and the time for hate, the time for war and the time for peace. And from verse 14, I know that everything God does will last forever. You can't hold anything to it or take away anything from it. And one thing God does is to make us stand in awe of him. May God bless the reading of his word. Amen.
Thank you, Wilma. And yes, thanks be to God for his timeless word. We're going to reflect on those words in a moment, but first of all, we'll stand together again. We're going to sing 10,000 Reasons. 10,000 reasons for blessing God, for thanking God for all that he does. So let's stand together and sing 10,000 Reasons.
Lies before me.
Please all be seated. Ten thousand reasons to thank God and to worship Him, and even if you got to 10,000, there would be 10,000 more. Those of you who know your popular music will know that the song Turn, 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 written by Pete Seeger way back in the late 50s and made famous by the Byrds in 1965, you'll know that song is pretty much a word-for-word steal from the Bible and from the passage from Ecclesiastes that Wilma read for us. The song's been covered by endless folks, from Nina Simone to Dolly Parton to Bruce Springsteen and almost everyone else. But when the song comes on the radio, and it still does, I would sing it for you, but I wouldn't put you through that. I do wonder how many listeners recognize that it comes from the Scriptures of the Old Testament. The words, therefore, are absolutely timeless, and they speak to every generation and to every person who will listen. The essential theme, of course, is that there is a time for everything. Let me begin by saying what that doesn't mean. It doesn't mean that there is a time for everything in the sense that you've got all the time in the world. You don't. In case you think you have, I'll say it again, you don't. When we tell ourselves that we've got all the time in the world, the danger is that we never get round to doing that which is most important. Telling ourselves that there will be time for that later. The Latins have a word, don't they? Mañana. Tomorrow. The harsh reality is that none of us knows what time we have, and it makes sense, therefore, that we have priorities in life, those things which are most important to us. There's nothing sadder than listening to someone tell you that they wished they had made better use of their years, that they had given themselves to the right stuff. You do not hear many people, if any, saying that they wished they had spent longer in the office. But you hear plenty of others saying they wished they had had more time with their children when they were growing up. The question each of us must ask is, what really matters? What are the most important things in life, and what do I need to give myself to? There's not time for everything in one life, so you better know how to use your time. And that's true whether you've got what seems like all of life stretching out in front of you, or whether you're in the twilight years. For some, it may be about career and family, and for others, it will be deciding, what do I want to do with the time that remains to me? That's not depressing, it's saying, this is the time, and what am I going to do with it? So there's not time for everything. And if that's true, then we do need to ask, what did the writer of Ecclesiastes mean when he wrote that there is a time for everything? The sense is this, that there are seasons in life, and the wisdom is in knowing what's required of us in each particular season. And more than that, the wisdom is in accepting that there are seasons in life over which you have no control whatsoever, and through which we need to exercise humility and trust that God is in it all. For example, I do not choose when I come into this world and am born. And neither do I choose when my life shall end. That's why I am hugely uneasy with the proposals now before the Scottish Parliament that, if passed, will pave the way to assisted suicide. There's a time for everything, and some of it is in God's hands and should be left in God's hands. But there are other seasons through which we live, and it's for us to judge how to act within these seasons, that is, how to read the signs of the times. Just as the farmer knows when the time is right to plant, so he knows when to start gathering in the harvest. In the same way, there are right times for all the different parts of life. For example, there are times when to speak, to encourage someone, to comfort someone, to build someone up, to thank someone. But there are times when to hold your tongue, to be silent, when perhaps the temptation was to spread a word of gossip, to criticize, to bring someone down. Sometimes, when with someone who has been bereaved, no words are required, just your comforting presence. So you see, there are seasons, times to talk, and times when best not to. There's time for everything. There are times for searching, for looking after that which seems to be elusive, for inquiring, for wondering. And there are times when you just have to let go and to accept. There are times to hang on to something, to keep it safe, to cherish it, to possess it. And there are times when to discard things, to let them go and to declutter and to give away. There's a time for everything. There are times for mourning, and not least when a friend or loved one has lost someone who is dear. Friends stand in solidarity with those who mourn. But so too, we should dance and rejoice and celebrate when a friend enjoys success or receives good news. There's time for everything. There are times to love friends and enemies, the poor and the needy, the widow and the orphan, and nothing higher than the love of the Lord Jesus Christ. But so too, as the passage tells us, there are times to hate injustice, to hate oppression in the world and persecution, to hate when vulnerable and innocent people are abused, to hate everything that runs contrary to the will of God. Hate that with a passion, just as you love with a passion. There's time for everything. And just as that is true in the lives of individuals and families and communities and nations, so it's true in terms of the life of a church. We might well look back and see the COVID pandemic as marking a changing of seasons for churches. And it might be that those churches that only want to rewind the clock back before March of 2020, that these churches will struggle to survive, while those that are ready to embrace the new thing will be those that thrive. Even now, within the life of this congregation, we're witnessing something of a changing of seasons. See how in recent years we've embraced digital technology. See how the ways we worship have evolved according to need and as the times change. No doubt there will be more of that. And some of our groups and organizations are witnessing the ends of seasons, in some cases which have lasted 60 years. And while we sound a lament for that and give thanks for all that was achieved in those years, let us be open for the new things that God is always doing. Friends, the good news is that God is with us in every season. There's a time for everything, and in everything, God is present to us. For the promise is that God in Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. Nothing else remains the same. Nothing else is constant and predictable. Everything is up for grabs other than God in Jesus, who is the same now and tomorrow. God is with us through all of life, through every season. It is these assurances, having that anchor for our soul, that will surely carry us through even the toughest of times. Knowing that God is with us when days are bright mountaintop sunshine and days of valleys and deep sorrow. It is these assurances that will hold us fast and through which we might prove ourselves to be sure and steadfast, as the words on this flag declare. Sure and steadfast through the storms of life that threaten to cast us adrift from our moorings and from the safety of the harbour. It is these assurances that God is always with us that will give us strength for today and hope for tomorrow, as we continually faithfully onwards through all the seasons of life. Surely there is a time for everything, but even more surely, God is with us through all of it. May you find that to be true in your life, that God is the anchor, that He holds you fast, and that with God in the mix, you are and will never, ever be alone. Let us reflect on that truth now through the words of this song. I am not alone. Let it be your song.
Through the
You know, if I had one hope today, one wish, it would be that you would leave church with that imprinted on your heart and soul, that you're not alone, that God goes with you, and that He is the anchor for souls in all of life. Friends, we worship today, we rejoice in who God is and what God has done, and yet there are reasons why this also is a sad day. Yet a day to remember and give thanks for the life of the 7th Arbroath Company of the Boys' Brigade, a life of essentially 60 years. That's over 2,000 evenings of fun and instruction, learning and service, all promoting Christ and His kingdom. That's countless boys and young men, many being shaped in one way or another by the life of the brigade. That's countless hours of devotion to duty by a long line of officers and helpers, too many to mention, but names like Spink and Tasker, and of course, Matthew and Ewart, being a constant thread through it all. Today, let us lament the end of a season, but let us do so in a spirit of gratitude for all that has been. Later in our proceedings, we will be presenting a Queen's badge. When one we will mention in absentia, one Robert is here with us. The last, as it were, in a long line of boys who have come all the way through and reached the pinnacle of achievement in the Boys' Brigade. So that is to come, as well as a special ceremony which is laid down for moments like this. It's called the laying up of the colours, and we will come to that in a moment. But I want to invite Wilma to come forward, if you will, Wilma, and if you would go to the lectern and address our gathering.
It is with mixed emotions I stand here today to bring to an end the company of the 7th Arbroath BB. We set sail September 1960 and were registered at headquarters on the 11th of January 1961 and on the 11th of June 2021, which would have been our final display, we dropped anchor. My father, Errol Matthew, started the company up with approval from the new minister of the newly formed St Andrew's Church, Reverend Ian MacLeod. The first captain was Mr J. Napier, then in 1963 to 85, Alex Spink Sr. Errol Matthew took over as temporary captain and remained in office until he retired in 2011, when I inherited the role. We were part of the Angus Battalion and took part in many activities. Most memorable were the Sportagamas, Sports Day, swimming galas, etc. And we joined with the Dundee Battalion in 2003. And today I welcome our president of the battalion, Roddy Taylor, and I first welcome to Simon, the development worker within Carnvale. Thank you both for being with us today. Throughout our 60 years, there have been some memorable moments. Our company colours were presented by Provost R.R. Spink, a member of our congregation, in November 1964. Our annual trips around Scotland and beyond to the Zoo, the Science Museum, Craigton Park, even to York. This Is Your Life night to mark our 25th anniversary, which we sprang on my dad when he thought half of Arbroath had stopped speaking to him in the street for fear of giving the show away. The big event in 1995 at Strathclyde Park, we were hosted by the second Hamilton, who were family friends. Our company went from strength to strength with many officers and helpers along the way, too numerous to mention, fear of missing anyone out. Our anchor section came along in 1983. Each section met on the same night, and we had a close bond with officers and parents as the boys progressed through each section. We are very proud as a small company to have been able to produce 40 Queen's Men, of whom some are sitting here today. A new millennium dawned, and in 2001, we held our 40th anniversary celebrations. We put on a show at our display night here in the church, Joseph and his technicolour dream coat, with our own boys in starring roles. That year also saw my dad appointed an MBE for services to the brigade within the Angus Battalion, of which he was president at the time, and received it more to honour the brigade than for himself. The captain of a ship needs a crew, and I have been very fortunate to have dedicated officers and helpers these past 10 years. I thank you for all your years' service to this company. To our chaplain, the very Reverend Martin Fair, for almost 30 years you have given us guidance and support to help us with the work of the brigade. And to Roddy Taylor, our current battalion president, a great support to us over the years as our Queen's Badge advisor. Thank you. Thank you from us all here at 7th Arbroath. You, the congregation, have played your part over the years in your support of our coffee mornings, jumble sales, remember them, Beetle Drive, quiz nights, and our annual display and awards night. I would like to give special thanks to our church officer and administrator, Janice and Linda, for their great care and preparations for today. No mean feat in these COVID restriction times. And to Karen for the lovely floral displays here today. In recent years, we have supported a child in Malawi through the Delitzo Project and been pleased to learn of the progress they have made in their lives due to our support. I could go on and would probably miss out something or somebody, so I will stop with my reflections and turn now to our officers and boys here with us today and watching online. Mandy and Tom, along with Cameron, could not be with us today. We wish them well and uphold them in our thoughts and prayers and look forward to acknowledging their achievements when fit to do so. To the boys here today, you will remember your time in the brigade, and I hope you go on to achieve your life dreams. And with the words of William Barclay in my mind, how to be happy, remember the word joy. J stands for Jesus, O stands for others, and Y stands for yourself. Put Jesus first, others second, and yourself last. That is the way to be happy. Try it today and see. To the officers and helpers, to Michael, Keith, Craig, Andrew, Sharon, Holly, and Karen, I leave you with these thoughts. 100 years from now, it will not matter what your bank account was, the sort of house you lived in, or the kind of car you drove, but the world may be different because you were important in the life of a child. It has been an honour and a privilege to have served this company. God bless you all.
Shall we recognise Wilma? Wilma, through all the years, you've never failed to find the right words. And same was true today. I personally will long remember Joy. Jesus, others, you. Something else for us to take with us today. I'm going to invite you now to stand in your places for the ceremony of the laying up of the colours. The officers will parade these colours into our sanctuary now. We have appropriate music now. Thank you, Louise. Please stand. Wrong one. Please be seated. We're gathered together in this church to lay up these colours of the 7th Arbroath Company of the Boys' Brigade. No more fitting place could be found wherein to deposit these emblems of duty and service than the House of God, where praise and prayer are wont to be made. I receive these colours for safe custody within this church.
Of course, the colours will find their place here at the front of our church as a reminder of all that has been and as we look forward to all that will be. Final part of the day is to make an award of the Queen's Badge. And so, Michael, as lead officer in the company section, I will invite you to inform us of this award.
Good morning. What is the Queen's Badge? Put simply, it is the highest award a boy can achieve in the Boys' Brigade. It is the culmination of his Boys' Brigade career, according to the time and involvement he has made over the course of up to a decade in his company, his battalion, and the brigade as a whole. For the company, it rewards the Queen's Badge candidate for his dedicated service as a member of the company section, and a non-commissioned officer in either the anchor or junior sections. It is also an affirmation of the time and efforts the officers have invested, as well as a morale boost and example to the rest of the boys, demonstrating what they too can accomplish. For the church, the Queen's Badge gives the boy ample opportunity to explore their faith. During the training courses that top and tail the 18-month-long programme, they have discussed and developed this faith journey with other candidates from all over central Scotland, who all come from a variety of backgrounds and life experiences, and returned with a renewed sense of purpose, direction, and determination. As part of their Queen's Badge, each candidate must undertake to complete 30 hours of voluntary activity. This provides the individual with a chance to engage with their community, contribute to it, take responsibility within it, and gain a sense of belonging. The Brigade has been bringing hope to communities and young people for nearly 140 years. With each candidate reaching out to different parts of this community and expanding its recognition and influence, the impression of the Brigade will only strengthen and grow. As for the boys themselves, gaining the Queen's Badge represents achievement of personal objectives, as it is they who decide what activities they will be pursuing. It is a very rewarding experience, one that they will look back on with a great deal of happiness and satisfaction in the years to come. Looking forward, it makes the young person stand out to any future employers. When they state they have the Queen's Badge on their resume, it shows a level of long-term voluntary dedication, especially as the work has taken place during a very busy time in the candidate's life, what with exams, part-time jobs and other external pressures. Each and every boy that gains the Queen's Badge, as well as being the realisation of every officer's aspirations, represents the fulfilment of the object of the Boys' Brigade, the advancement of Christ's kingdom among boys, and the promotion of habits of obedience, reverence, discipline, and self-respect, and all that tends towards a true Christian manliness. Tom Christensen and Robert Thompson have, through hard work and determination, and in this most difficult times of isolation, virtual meetings and social distancing, stepped up to the challenge and accomplished everything that was asked of them. They have joined a long line of young men for whom their time in the Brigade has reached its zenith, as well as its conclusion. It should make us all proud that a relatively small company such as ours have been able to nurture, encourage and inspire these boys and all of those who have come before them, especially given the poignancy of this, what will be our last service honouring newly awarded Queen's Men of the 7th Arbroath Company. Thank you.
Thank you, Michael. And let's honour Michael as well for all that he has done. I'm going to ask Roddy if you would come forward, please, and present now to Robert his certificate and badge. Tom, as you will be aware, due to ill health and what unfortunate timing, can't be here today, but in time, of course, will receive his award as well. Robert, would you now step forward, please, to receive your Queen's badge and certificate? Just turn around and stay. Wilma has organised a memento for each of the officers, and at the end, these are all named. Please come and receive them, but it would be wrong not to have a thank you for Wilma. And so for all that you have done and your family, and for today, for the words you brought to us, Wilma, thank you very much. Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Almighty and everlasting God, yes, there is a time for everything. As some seasons draw to an end, others begin. We move now from summer into autumn, and winter will come, but so too in its time, spring, new life. And so therefore we pray for signs of life as we go forward through this pandemic and beyond. Signs, Lord, that you are present to us. Signs that you are active among us. signs that the one who raised Jesus from the dead is still in the business of bringing new life. So to all gathered here today and online, to all who need to hear that good news of new life, we pray that by your Spirit, you would indeed communicate these words. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. It would be sacrilegious almost not to finish today by singing, "Will Your Anchor Hold?" It takes us right back to the truths that Jesus is the anchor for our souls and will keep us sure and steadfast through every season of life. So we stand and sing, "Will Your Anchor Hold?" There is an introduction and then I will lead you into the song. Thank you, Louise. And may the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you today and forevermore. Amen.
Shine upon you and be gracious.
with the Lord's blessing upon us, we make our way now from the sanctuary. If you have children with you that are through in the hall, please go that way as you collect your children. Otherwise, we leave the church from the back rows and leaving from there in order to the front. Bless you as you go, and I look forward to you being here again that we might worship together. The Lord bless you and keep you.